Hello YouTube, Temba here. Today I'm gonna show you how to connect to my SQL database using method B. Yes, method B. There we go. This is the application we created previously. It was able to delete, insert data, update data, and collect data from the database table. So, but now, as you can recall, this connection component came through the drag and drop from this connection here. Okay, so if you can remember, we did drag and drop something like this, as you can see. Okay, we did drag and drop something like this. Sorry about that, like this. See, so but now I'm gonna show you how to do it without coming through the data explorer. Okay, as for the query, you do remember, however, that we just came and took it manually from this DB Express collection here. So let's now delete this connection here and connect without using the data explorer. So we're gonna drag and drop the SQL connection and put it there. Okay, and I'm gonna name it con. Okay, after that you're gonna change the driver to MySQL. Okay, but this doesn't mean it will just connect. Okay, the user, the password, and the user. And by the way, you need to change this login prompt to false. Okay, and then so you do have a connection, it's having a driver name, MySQL, and everything. But now when the form gets shown, you're gonna go to event on show here, you're gonna paste this code. Okay, not you, me, I'm gonna paste it because I already have it on the clipboard. You're gonna clear all the parameters of con. Okay, you know which one is con? Oh, I don't know. Okay, let me show you which one is con. Con is this component we just dropped now here. Okay, I named it con. As you can see, the name is con. So the parameters I'm referring to this thing here. If you can click here, you can see all these are parameters, all of them. So it's gonna clear all of them. Okay, we are interested in this host name, database, username, and password. Okay, the rest will automatically be added the moment you set the driver name here. Okay, for example, I'm gonna change the driver name now to SQLite. Yeah? If you go to parameters, you can see that they automatically changed. Okay, so we're gonna go for MySQL. Okay, MySQL. After that, when the form gets shown, as you can see here, we're gonna clear all the parameters and we're gonna select the driver name to MySQL like this, the username like that, the password like that, the local host, I mean the server like that, which is the host name, the database name where we can run this database. And then after this is simple, you can just say this dot connected connected equal to true. Once you say so, you say the query connection SQL connection is equal to con. Just like that, you are done. So let's try and run the program and see if it works. When the form code gets shown, we're gonna execute this portion of code here. So meaning if it connected successful, we should be able to insert, collect data and everything. as you can see. It gave us results, meaning it was able to connect successfully. If the connection was never successful, it was not going to give us the results, okay? Yeah, it's working fine. So, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanted to show you how to connect without going to the Data Explorer, okay? And by using the basic database components from DB Express. Of course, if you want to use the advanced one, you're gonna go and grab yourself UniDeck, okay? UniDeck is another set of components for connecting to all the databases that you can think of, okay? And they are more advanced, by the way, but they can do pretty much everything that DB Express can do. So you can always choose which one you prefer. But for this video, I just wanted to show you, in case you don't know where to get or you don't know how to get the UniDeck, you can always use the one that you just found here, the DB Express ones. As you can see, I just demonstrated everything using a simple DB Express component, okay? So let me see, this video is 6 minutes, so meaning I can still show you more. But I think I'm gonna show you more in the next video. I don't even know what I'll record in the next video, but I will figure out. Yeah, on the next video, I'm gonna show you how to develop a commercial application that you can put it at the market and sell it. Yes, commercial, I mean an application that have that look and feel. Okay. For example, let's see if I can give an example of the. This is the application I was working on. Let's see if. Let's see if it works fine. Okay, so this application is refusing because the server is not running, so it's fine. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, thanks for watching. I will figure out what to record on the next video. I hope you enjoyed it. Like and subscribe.